to the third experiment of our AMILAB 1 thermal. Today we will discuss the pin fin apparatus. So this is the pin fin apparatus. You can see the heat transfer from pin fin. So we will know what is fin, what are the types of fin, what type of fin we have considered here, why we have considered such type of fin. But the objective of the experiment is, number one, to find the heat transfer coefficient H, which is the convective heat transfer coefficient in terms of watt per meter square Kelvin or watt per meter square degree Celsius. Number two, we will find the efficiency of the fin. And number three, we will find, we will determine the effectiveness of the fin. Now, this, so there are 3 points, there are three objectives. At the end of the today's class, the students, you will be able to understand or you will be able to determine how the efficiency, the effectiveness and heat transfer coefficient of a fin is determined. But obviously, before finding out the efficiency and the effectiveness of the fin, you need to know what is the value of H. If the H value is not known to you or you are not able to find out, you cannot find efficiency and effectiveness. Well, now what is a fin? A fin is a substance or it is a extra added material to a engine or a heated body, so that the effective heat transfer or the heat transfer rate can be improved or enhanced. So a fin is a extra area or extra material which improves the rate of heat transfer from a heat dissipating surface. Say our engine of a bike or a car, we are having radiator or we are having engine. We will see outside the engine there are some extended portion or extended area. These are the fins, because if these are not used, so the heat transfer rate will not be improved. So there may be a chance that the temperature of the heat dissipating element will increase further, and it may happen that the engine will melt down or it will malfunction. So in order to improve the heat transfer rate, we use fin. Now there are two terms, fin efficiency and fin effectiveness. Now what do you mean by efficiency? The efficiency of a fin is defined as the ratio of actual heat transfer by the fin to the maximum possible heat transfer by the fin. So actual by maximum. Say when you design the fin, say maximum heat transfer rate is say 6 watt, okay, in terms of heat transfer, or say 0.6 kilowatt or whatever, say 6 watt. Now if we use the fin, say you have got after the experiment, the fin has actually transferred a heat of 4 watt. So what is the fin efficiency? 4/6. That means, say approximately 75%, 70% like that. Now what do you mean effectiveness? Say, if the fin is not used here in the experiment, what will happen? The heat transfer rate will not be improved, but there will be some heat transfer, obviously less than what we can expect here. Now what will happen if we use the fin? It will increase, it will enhance. So the effectiveness of a fin is defined as the ratio of the heat transferred by the fin, or the heat transfer of the surface or the engine with the fin, divided by the heat transfer without the fin. That means heat transfer rate increase using the fin to the heat transfer rate without using the fin. Now obviously, as we know that the fin is used to enhance the heat transfer, so of course the numerator part will be higher than the denominator part, and the quantity will be more than one. So the efficiency of fin is a quantity which is less than one, but the effectiveness of the fin will obviously be larger than one, higher than one. Okay. Now, why it is a forced convection? Because the experiment is pin fin apparatus. Now there are different types of fin: square fin, P pin fin, cylindrical fin, like this. Here we are having a pin fin of small diameter. The diameter of the fin given is 12 mm or 0.012 meter, and the length of the fin given is 150 mm, that means 0.150 meter in length. So we are having a small size cylindrical fin. We are treating it as a pin fin, and here we will do the experiment twice. First part, today we will discuss the heat transfer, the convective heat transfer, which is forcefully, that means forced convection. The next class we will discuss the same fin which will be acted upon or which will be operating under free or natural convection. Now, what do you mean by free or natural, and what do you mean by forced? If you can look at the experimental setup, see, there is a blower, there is a heater here, there is a heater here. Why we are using the heater? Because this is the fin, you can see, this is the fin which is attached with the heater. So the portion of the fin which is just touching the heater, that adjacent portion is the fin base. It is called T naught or TB, B for base. And the extreme portion of the fin, this side, is called the tip side. And you can see, we have tried to insulate this. You can see over here, we have tried to insulate this. Why? In order to make the two-dimensional heat transfer into one-dimensional. This phenomena we will discuss in the blackboard few minutes later. So here the heater, why? So that we can give some amount of heat flux over there. The heat is being transferred from the base towards the tip. So this is the TB, T base, and throughout the length 150 mm there are 5 thermocouples. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 thermocouples, and the distance between each thermocouple is 30 mm. So say this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here in the temperature measuring knob, if you can rotate the knob, you can see it will give the reading of T1, T2, then T3, then T4, then T5. Now if 1 to 5, the temperatures are known, if we average T1, T2, T3, T4 and T5, we can find the average surface temperature of the fin. Say it is TS, T surface of the fin. And what is 6 here? 6 is the ambient, that temperature outside the experiment or the room temperature. So this is the T6. So obviously, since the fin is being heated from the heater, the source, so T1 to T5 will be larger than T6. And if we take the average of the surface temperature TS, average surface temperature of the fin, and the ambient temperature T6, we can find TMF, M for mean, F for film. So this is called mean film temperature. Why? Now, before this answer why, we are interested to know why this experiment is forced convection. If you can see here, this red color channel is the duct through which the air will blow. Why blow? Because there is a motor, so there is an electrical input, okay? So this motor is actually, it is actually a centrifugal blower which sucks or takes in the air from the ambient through this side, and you can see the fin, and you can see the fin is like this. It is like this. It is not like this or not like this. Since the fin is like this, and you can see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 holes, 5 thermocouples have been attached. When the air will blow like this, it will suck the air. So the air will move over the cylindrical fin or the pin fin. So the the length of travel of the air for the fin is the equal to the diameter. So the characteristic length here of the fin is equal to the diameter of the fin, which is 12 mm. Okay, so this is very important. Now, since we are using a blower, now what this blower is doing, you can see, this is the blower. And one U-tube manometer is attached here with, so that you can find the pressure difference of the water. From that, you can find what is the pressure head available at the at this point. So from that, you can find what is the velocity, and ultimately, if you know the area of the orifice into the velocity of air, you can find what is the mass flow rate, because the product of area of the orifice into the volume flow rate, that means density into volume flow rate, will give you the mass flow rate of air, and you can see the air is coming out there. Okay, now why we are interested in forced convection? Because here the flow of air, we know in case of convection there must be a bulk flow of fluid, there must be a flow of fluid from one place to another place, so that the nearby molecules are being replaced and the far away molecules of the air will approach the heated portion. There will be a heat exchange. We know that that convection is such a mode of heat transfer which is conduction assisted advection. So here you can see that when the air is blown, is sucked, so near the wall, say if this is the fin, so when the air will stuck here, so over the surface, when the air will touch, so there will be pure conduction. But since there is a bulk flow of air, so there will be advection. And we know the sum of advection, the bulk motion of the fluid, as well as conduction at the solid fluid interface, this is the conduction. So advection assisted by conduction is actually the convection. So this is a convective heat transfer, and the heat loss by the fin is a convection, and that heat loss at steady state is taken entirely by the air that is approaching. Now we have to wait for half an hour or 1 hour, so that at a certain velocity or a pressure gradient of the blower, we can achieve a steady state, so that there is, so that we don't achieve a further any type of blink or any type of ambiguity or non-equilibrium phase in the readings. Okay, so then only we can tell that the steady state is being reached by the entire setup. So we have to wait for some time, because in the previous lectures also, in the previous lab class also, I have told you people that in this heat transfer lab, you must wait for a sufficient amount of time, because the setup is being will be heated, and every material will radiate some heat, every material may take some heat. And after this heat interaction, a time will come when the rate of heat loss by any substance or any portion will be equal to the heat gain. So that the temperature equilibrium is established. So under that given circumstances or given load or given parameters, so whenever there is will be no change in the reading, that is the steady state condition. Because if there is a blinking of any reading, if the temperature is not reached steady, if steady state is not reached, we cannot achieve a perfect reading or perfect experiment. Now this one, if you can look at this green color casing, is the casing of the blower. Now there is a centrifugal motor which sucks the air towards the fin. The air from the ambient, which is at ambient temperature, is not at ambient, because why? The fin is heated. The ambient is at T6 or T ambient temperature. say today's temperature is say 32. You can see over here 29.2. This is the ambient temperature today. You can see the reading. But since T1 to T5 is higher than T6, you can see the reading T5. This is your T4 increase towards 1. T3 increase, T2 higher, T1 the highest, because T1 is attached or is the nearest position of T0 or T base. So if we take the average reading of 1 to 5, say we got a temperature say for example 35. Now since T6 is at 29.4, say we got a average say ultimately say 32 or whatever, or say 33 or 32.5, whatever. So we have seen that the temperature of the fin is not as it was in the initial stage. Even the temperature of the air which is approaching due to the blower, due to the convective heat transfer, is also changing. So what you have to take, this is the TMF. We will not take TF, the fin temperature. We will not even take T6 or TMBN or T infinity, because we will take the average of ambient and average of surface temperature of the fin. So T1 to 5, first we will average, we will find T surface, average surface temperature of the fin, say TS, say we got 35. Now T6 we know, TMBN 29.4, take the average, say 32.5 or 33, whatever, that will be your TMF, M for mean, F for film, that F is not for fin. So that is called mean film temperature. Why? Now the significance or the importance of mean film temperature is, since the in the entire convective heat transfer experiment, the temperature, the effective temperature, if we assume, so the significance of TMF, that is the mean film temperature, is that we assume that the, as if the entire convective heat transfer is occurring at the temperature of TMF, which is not equal to the fin temperature or average fin temperature. Even it is not equal to the ambient temperature, it is the average. And all the properties, all the thermal properties like mu, that means dynamic viscosity, density rho, then kinetic viscosity mu, then thermal conductivity of air K, all these properties of air must be calculated or must be find out from that or corresponding to the TMF value. We remember, don't take any reading corresponding to T6 or TS or T1 to 5. So ultimately, if we get the value TMF, that means the average temperature of fin and ambient, that will give you the entire idea how the air is behave or how the air will behave. All the properties of air, all the thermal properties of air, there is a chart. We will provide you the chart. Already all are given in the manual. In the next session, I will show you how to take different readings after. So first you have to find TMF. Now, as we are sure that this is a forced convection, because we are using the blower, so we are trying to force the air towards or suck the air inside. So I am trying for a bulk motion of the fluid, which is air here, forcefully. That's why it is a forced convection. And as we know, when the fluid, there is a bulk flow, which is not natural. Natural means what? The convective heat transfer will be dominating by the natural phenomenon. That means hot air is at higher temperature than the cold air. So we know that since the temperature of hot air is higher than the temperature of a cold air, what will happen? The air molecules near the fin will be heated, and the air molecules near away from the fin are cold. So obviously the hot air will take the heat, since they are heated, the temperature is high, they are lighter in weight, their weight or their you can say their density is quite less, lighter in weight, so they will rise up. And at the same time, the colder air, they are heavier in weight, so they will try to rearrange and they will try to replace the hot those hot air vacuums or the places. So in this way, there will be a current, natural current between the hot air and the cold air, that is under free or a natural convection. So why free or why natural? Since that heat transfer, there we will not use any external medium or external agency or external means for flow of air. Whatever is the heat loss or convective heat transfer or convection is entirely due to the temperature rise of the hot air. Due to the temperature rise, the hot air density will be less. They will try to move up naturally, and the cold air will try to replace those places. So a natural current means flow, a natural bulk flow or the fluid will take place between the hot air and the cold air, that is under natural convection. Here we are trying to achieve the bulk motion or the bulk flow of the air forcefully, that's why it is forced convection. Now if you can see here, a forced convection, since the air is given a force, so we can say that when air is flowing in a high velocity, obviously the Reynolds number, RE, the Reynolds number will play an important role. And in we know, in case of convective heat transfer, Prandtl number obviously is very important. Now what is Reynolds number? It is a dimensionless number in fluid mechanics, which is represented by or which is signifies as the ratio of inertia force to viscous force. And what is Prandtl number? It is the ratio of the total or the convective heat transfer rate in a convection divided by or to the rate of conduction in that convection, because we know that convection is conduction plus advection. So the total phenomena is the convection. So the total heat transfer rate, that means the convective heat transfer rate divided by the conduction heat transfer in the convection. Now the Prandtl number is given by H into LC by K. What is H here? This H is the convective heat transfer coefficient. What is the LC? C for character. So this is called characteristics length. In the first few minutes earlier, we have discussed that since the fin is placed like this and the air is blowing crosswise and it is cylindrical fin, so what will be the characteristic length, LC, diameter of the fin? So here you can write H into dia of the fin by K. Now which K? Here there are two K. One is, what is K? K is, we know from the first experiment, K is the thermal conductivity of the material. Now here is two different thermal conductivity. One is the fin material. We are using brass for the fin material, and since we are using the air table corresponding to the TMF value, the mill film temperature, so again the K of air will come, there is fluid. Which K will take here? In case of Prandtl number, all the K will be the K of air, all the K. In case of PR, H into LC by K of the fluid, don't take the K of the fin material. Here we are using brass, so the K of the brass, so K of the fin material, KF, is 110, or you can say 109. Okay, you get a 100 whatever. Watt per meter Kelvin or degree Celsius, whatever. It is given. Since the material is known, given. Now, so in case of forced convection, you can see the Nusselt number is a function of Reynolds number and Prandtl number. What is Reynolds number? We told you inertia force by viscous force. So rho into V, the velocity of air, into LC by mu. Now what is mu by rho? Mu is dynamic viscosity of air. So mu air, rho air, V air. Okay? You can write, what is mu by rho? Nu. Sorry, nu. That means, what is nu? Mu by rho. That means, dynamic viscosity by density. This nu is called a kinematic viscosity of air. So, mu by air, here LC is DF, and what is V of air? This V of air, we will find from the YouTube manometer. There we will get the pressure difference. We will know the orifice area. From there, we can find out what is the velocity of air which is approaching the fin. Okay? Though we have to neglect some little bit amount of pressure loss. Okay? So, in forced convection, Nusselt number, now what is Nusselt number? Okay. Sorry, this one is the Nusselt number, H into L by K. Now what is PR? So Nusselt number is the ratio of the heat transfer in convection to the heat transfer in conduction, H into L C by K. Now what is PR? PR is the ratio of nu by rho. PR is nu by alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is the thermal diffusivity. And what is nu? Nu is the kinematic viscosity. So, one is fluid property, another is thermal property. So, ratio of these two, or you can say, it is also the ratio of delta by delta T. That means, the ratio of hydrodynamic boundary layer to thermal boundary layer. This is PR. So from the chart of the air at TMF, we can find what is PR. So PR is known, RE is known. Now what is NU? What is the relationship? This C is a constant. N and M are two coefficients, power index. Generally, the value of M, the index power of PR, is generally 1/3 for air. And generally, or naturally, normally it is the value of N is 1/2, near about 0.4 to 0.8. Now, this will vary, depends on the value of RE. See, when RE is 0.4 to 4, there is a separate value of C and N. When RE is 4 to 40, separate value. RE is 40 to 4000, separate. RE is 4000 to 40,000 separate. So, RE up to 4 lakh separate. So, after the experiment is conducted, first we have to find what is RE. If RE is, say, in this range, so we have to put this value of C and this value of N in this expression or equation. So, C will be known, M is 1/3 already known, N will be known. RE and PR we will find out. RE will be found out from the calculation and PR from the air chart or air table. So we can find NU. Once we have found out NU, now what is NU? H into LC by K. LC is DF here. We have already told the cataclysmic length is equal to the dia of the fin here in the experiment. Since the fin is placed like this, if the fin is placed like this and the air is blowing like this, then the LC will be equal to the length of the fin. But since the fin is placed like this and the air is approaching like this, so what is the length? The diameter of the rod, the fin. So DF is known to us, how much? 12 mm, that is 0.012 meter. Now, LC is known. K of air, we will find out from the TMF value, corresponding to the TMF value, we will find from the air table. So, what is the objective? Our first objective was to find the H. So, we can find the H, the average heat transfer coefficient of that entire forced convective heat transfer experiment. So, the first objective is over. Now, first I told you that there are different types of fin. Now, we are here assuming a fin of insulated tip. Now, what is the meaning? So, this is the main engine or the main heated metal with which the fin is attached. So, the junction of the fin, the common surface of the fin and the hot metal is called the base, from where the fin is started. And the extreme portion of the fin which is exposed to ambient is called tip. Now, if we insulate this, why? So that the mathematical analysis or the differential calculus can be simplified. How? Now, when there will be a convective heat loss from the fin, say it is x in y direction, so heat loss will be both in x, y direction. If you consider 3D, x, y, z. If we consider cylindrical r theta, whatever, we are say first considering 2D. So, it will be only conduction. Now, how is the heat loss? First, the heat from here, because there is a heater. So, V into I. So, from the heater, the heat will come here. So, from T naught, it will come to, so this portion is called T naught. That means the base temperature or TB. From the point B or O or not, it will come to 1. So, 1 is most heated or most or the highest temperature. Then T2, then T3, then T4, then T5. What is T6? Ambient. Now, here the heat is being lost both in XY direction. If we have want to simplify the analysis or if we want to convert this 2D analysis into 1D, if we use an insulation here, that means no heat will be transferred here. Okay, so the heat transfer along the X has been neglected here. That's why we have insulated this. Now, if you can ask, sir, we have insulated the tip. Who has given us that right? Very, very vital point. Say the total length is given, so 1 meter. What I have assumed? It was 2D heat transfer. What I have done, I have reduced the one-dimensional heat transfer. So, I have only allowed one-dimensional. So how that negativity or that restriction has been overcome or compensated? How? I told you that the total length of the fin is 150 mm, that means 0.15 meter. Now, if I had to insulate this, how much length has to be added in the fin, how much length has to be added in the fin virtually so that the heat transfer rate before and after the 2D to 1D conversion by the tip insulation is being same. For that, the effective length of the fin L star, effective length of the fin is given by the length of the fin itself plus the area by perimeter. So, this you have to add with the length of the fin if you want to get a proper reading or a proper parameter evaluation. So, A by P, what is A? A is the cross-sectional area of the fin. So, it is a cylindrical in shape, so pi by 4 d square. What is P? P is the periphery or perimeter, pi d. So, what is A by P? DF by 4. So, now The unit of df is in mm or meter. Unit of L is in meter. So if you can add, so instead of LF, the length of fin, we will take length of fin plus 1/4 of the dia of the fin, which is very small, but you have to still take. Why? Because conceptually, when you are trying to restrict one mode of heat transfer, you cannot do it. You don't have any permission. So for that, you need some compensation. So we are compensating the heat loss as if we are adding some heat, length virtually, so that before and after the 2D to 1D conversion, by assuming the tip insulation, we can achieve the same rate of heat transfer. That's all. So this is the physical significance of the effective length and the original length. So this is the original length, and this is the extra length, virtual length added. So this is the effective length of the fin, which will be higher than LF. Okay. So these are the formulas of heat transfer by the fin. Which fin? The fin whose tip is insulated. For that type of fin only, if B is the base temperature. Now we told you what is TS average or TF average. The average fin temperature T1 to T5. So take the average of T1 to T5. Then come here, what is TMF? The average of T ambient and average of fin. That TMF is the most important in heat transfer, because all the fluid and thermal properties of air, or the fluid here, the air, are to be taken from the air table corresponding to that value. That time you cannot take this value or this value. Once you have found out TMF, all the fluid properties are to determine about or against TMF. Now here you can see, this is the expression of, this is the epsilon, means the effectiveness, and this is the efficiency. So what is efficiency? The actual heat transfer to maximum possible heat transfer. What is effectiveness? The rate of heat transfer with fin to the rate of heat transfer without fin. Now you can see, sir, you have written H bar here, average heat transfer coefficient in the convection, and you have taken only H here. Are the same? No. This H will come with 10. So this is the, so this is a hyperbolic function, sin h, cos h, say sin h theta, it is about theta, minus, it is about minus theta by 2, cos h theta, 10 h theta, that 10. So this is the hyperbolic function. Don't take this h to be here. This is not tan of h into ml, no. That's why tan h is the operator. What is m here? And this L, which L you take? You take L star. Don't take LF only. If you want to get a, so all will be L star. Okay. What is this m? This m, see, as we know, that sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, sine h theta, cos h theta, tan h theta, all are geometrical property. So that must be an angle, and we will get a value, say 0.5, 0.2, 1, 0, like this. A value in between, say, since 10, we will get a value in between 0 to 1, say 0.3, say 0.5, say 0.6. So that must be dimensionless. That must be in radian. Because sine theta, theta is in radian. So the unit of L is in mm or meter. So if m, we can arrange a property m in such a way that m is root over hp by ka. You can see, what is the unit of H? Watt per मीटर स्क्वायर केल्विन, पी मीटर, के वाट पर मीटर केल्विन, ए मीटर स्क्वायर. सो अल्टीमेटली यू विल गेट द यूनिट ऑफ एम टू बी से मीटर इनवर्स, दैट मीन वन बाय मीटर. सो व्हाई, सो व्हाट इज सिग्निफिकेंस सर? इफ द यूनिट ऑफ एम इज मीटर इनवर्स, दैट मीन्स लेंथ इनवर्स, वन बाय लेंथ. सो व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ एम इन टू एल? डायमेंशनलेस. इफ द यूनिट ऑफ एम इज लेंथ इनवर्स, सो एम इन टू एल विल गिव यू ए डायमेंशनलेस वैल्यू, से 0.5, 0.4, 0.8. सो माई ऑब्जेक्टिव इज सेटिस्फाइड, दिस इज एम. सो इफ यू नो द वैल्यू ऑफ एम, एल स्टार इज ऑलरेडी नोन, यू कैन फाइंड दिस वन एंड ऑल द थिंग्स यू ऑलरेडी नो. यू कैन फाइंड द एफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ द फिन एंड द एफिशियंसी ऑफ द फिन. सो आई एम टेलिंग यू अगेन, हियर इन केस ऑफ फोर्स्ड कन्वेक्शन, नसेल्ट नंबर व्हिच इज द मेन डायमेंशनलेस नंबर इन हीट इन कन्वेक्टिव हीट ट्रांसफर, व्हिच इज डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो ऑफ कन्वेक्टिव हीट ट्रांसफर रेट टू कंडक्शन हीट ट्रांसफर रेट, and is ultimately explained is h into lc by k. What is h? H is the convective heat transfer coefficient, lc is the characteristic length of the heat transfer. It may be sometimes diameter, it may be a certain length if it is over the flow. If it is internal flow, say there is a pipe, a fluid is hot fluid is flowing or a cold fluid is flowing, heat transfer say inside to outside or outside to inside, at that time what will be LC? Diameter. Because in the Reynolds number we have to take, because it is internal flow, when a fluid is flowing through a pipe we will take the diameter as the LC. Since here is the external flow, it may be diameter, it may be length, it depends on, say there is a surface like this, say air is blowing like this, air is blowing like this. So what is the LC? L, the length of this. Now say this is a pipe, air is entering like this, leaving like this, at that time diameter. Here in this case the fin is like this, air is approaching vertically, so cross flow. So what is the maximum length? Diameter. That's why LC is equal to diameter of the fin, DF. So that NU for forced convection will be dominated by Reynolds number, since forced convection, and PR. PR will obviously come, because whenever there is a convection, there is a thermal boundary layer as well as there is a hydrodynamic or fluid boundary layer. So ratio of hydrodynamic or fluid boundary layer to thermal boundary layer is approximately the Pendel number, or it is also defined as the ratio of nu to alpha. What is nu? Nu is kinematic viscosity of air. What is alpha? Alpha is thermal diffusivity of air. So you can see PR is such a property which tells us, or which governs us, whether the convection, or whether in the convection the hydrodynamic or the fluid properties or the fluid velocity or temperature etc., so whether the fluid properties are dominating over the thermal properties, or whether the thermal properties are dominating over the fluid properties. If in an experiment, if in an experiment we get PR say 0.7, say for air, normally free or forced PR value cannot be more than 0.8 or 0.9. If PR is 1, that means the performance or the dominance of hydrodynamic or fluid boundary layer as well as the thermal boundary layer is approximately same. If you use oil in industry, in the different heat exchanger, we are using a special type of oil. Okay,
industrial oils. Those, if we use that oils, sometimes it may happen the PR is more than one. But by using water, you cannot achieve more than one. But if you use air, you can not achieve more than 0.8. You will see the experiment, you will get a value of PR hardly 0.69, 0.7, 0.71, 0.72, like that. So it depends on the fluid. So it is a ratio of a fluid property, which is kinematic viscosity of air. So if you look at here, now what is nu? We know nu is nu by rho. What is nu? Nu is dynamic viscosity. And what is rho? Rho is density. So I can write nu by rho. And what is alpha? Alpha is thermal diffusivity, which is K by rho C. What is C? C is the specific heat of the fluid, of the element of the fluid. What is K? K is the thermal conductivity of the fluid. Rho, the density. So K by rho C. Or you can say rho Cp. Now rho is cancel. What you'll get? Mu the Cp by K. If you even don't know, or if in any air table the Prandtl number value is not, if you don't get, don't worry. How to find out? What to do? What is the value of TMF? Say you got a TMF of say 32.5, say for example. Corresponding to that, you have to only know what is the K of air, what is Cp of air, and what is mu of air. If you know mu, if you know Cp and K of the fluid, not the fin, here is the air. So you can find the Prandtl number. So either you collect the value of Prandtl number from the air table, or you can achieve this. So in the next class, that experiment will be continued. We will go directly to the experiment. We will take one entire reading and we will show you how to calculate step by step. First, you have to find what is the value of H. Because as you will know, the value of nu is H into LC by K. So K will be known to you, LC will be known to you, nu will get from RE and PR from here. So we will find H. So first objective is to find H. Once we have found out H or H bar, put it here. All the values you know. Okay, M and L already you know. What is M? H root over H by K. So you can find Q fin, the heat transfer rate with the fin. This is the actual heat transfer rate in terms of what? This much of what? Then we will find the effectiveness and efficiency. Okay, so in the next class, that means in the next week, the same class, we will see how from the experimental data we can find RE, PR, all will be obviously with respect to the TMF value from the air table, and how we will find out NU, and from NU we will find the average H value. From H we will find M, L, L will be known to you, and the heat transfer rate, effectiveness and efficiency. Thank you.